Since August 5th, 2021, the Aleutian Islands have been unusually active as three volcanoes are simultaneously erupting. Of these three volcanoes, the most notable eruption so far has originated from the Great Sitkin Volcano, which thus far has constructed a 1-kilometer-wide lava dome. Then, in early May of 2022, satellites began detecting an unusually high level of sulfur dioxide gas originating from the Mount Cleveland Volcano. Additionally, these same satellites detected that fumaroles around the volcano increased in temperature. As a result, on May 10th, the alert level of Mount Cleveland was raised from green to yellow by the Alaskan Volcano Observatory. Thus, it is quite possible that the state of Alaska might soon have four actively erupting volcanoes. Mount Cleveland is located in the central Aleutian Island chain where it is 45 miles west of the city of Nikolsky. It is surrounded by five other highly active volcanoes, hinting that a large body of magma is located at depth. Recent papers have even led to the suggestion that five of the six volcanoes are part of a potential supervolcano with a vast caldera as shown on the screen. However, this claim of it being part of a supervolcano is not yet proven. Mount Cleveland is the youngest of the regional volcanoes as indicated by its lack of thorough glacial erosion. In this manner, it has been suggested that the entire volcano may have formed in the last 10,000 years, suggesting an abnormally high eruptive rate. This hypothesis is supported by the fact that Mount Cleveland is one of the most active volcanoes in all of Alaska, erupting 30 times since 1890. These eruptions have generally followed the same pattern and were almost all volcanic in nature. During these eruptions, small lava domes would occasionally grow on Cleveland's summit. These lava domes would be composed of basaltic andesite to andesite lava and partially block the magma conduit. Pressure would then build underneath the dome until it became too great, causing a small ash-rich explosion to occur and ejecting large boulders from the lava dome. While individual eruptions have contained only a single explosion, Cleveland's typical eruption involves a sequence of explosions which occur several hours to days apart. On occasion, the lava domes grew over the summit crater, creating a flow of material which would then advance down the volcano's steep slopes. These lava flows typically do not travel far, but as indicated by the island's appearance, on occasion have reached up to 3 miles distant. At the present, Mount Cleveland is releasing unusually high levels of sulfur dioxide gas, which according to the Alaska Volcano Observatory, is at the high end of what has been observed at the volcano over the last several years. This suggests that a new intrusion of magma might be in the volcano's eruptive conduit. Sulfur dioxide is naturally released by degassing magma, so a sudden increase in gas levels is a strong indication of volcanic activity. Additionally, satellites have begun to detect a cluster of hotspots in the volcano, likely representing unusually warm fumaroles. I personally checked NASA datasets, and these did not detect a single hotspot at Cleveland from April 11th to May 7th. Then, on May 8th, and for every day since, a cluster of hotspots have been detected. I do want to note that satellite-derived temperatures are highly inaccurate. With this being said, these satellites suggested spots in the volcano were heated between 80 and 154 degrees Fahrenheit. Although this increased activity might make it seem like an eruption in the immediate future is inevitable, this is not necessarily true. A similar period of volcanic unrest occurred at this volcano beginning on March 20th of 2021, where a similar set of satellite observations were used to justify a raised yellow alert level. Cleveland would remain at this alert level for 7 months, during which an eruption did not occur. In the event Mount Cleveland was to erupt, it wouldn't heavily damage any areas of economic importance as the surrounding islands are completely uninhabited. With this being said, it might be best to avoid the airspace around this volcano for the time being. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my patron Adam Gatewood for supporting this channel.